Shanghai GDG is a very interesting developer community.
I'm glad somebody has asked this question.
This is where the magic happens.
This is primarily a question and answer show. So if any of you out there would like to ask questions.
Hey, and welcome to another episode of Google Payments Live. My name is Pong Ying. Unfortunately, Mihai can't be with us today. He's in Hawaii. Tough life, right? And joining me today is Mark Thomas. Mark, so tell us a little bit about yourself.
Hi, Pong. Hi, everyone out there. So my name is Mark, and I've been a PM at Google for about 2 years. And I'm a product manager on Google Wallet.
Cool. So tell us a little bit more about the product that you manage.
Sure. So right now I'm working on a project called Commerce Analytics. So what we're trying to do is build a suite of tools that help people that use Google to sell, like app developers, web and app developers, to better understand their business. So by focusing on analyzing purchase data, basically your sales data, we want to help make it more obvious how to make more money, how to improve your products, and how to get more customers.
Huh. So, I've used Google Analytics a little bit. Can you tell me how Commerce Analytics is going to be different from Google Analytics?
Sure. Good question. So Commerce Analytics is really focusing on your sales data and analyzing your sales data. Google Analytics provides metrics around bounce rates and page views. We are really, again, focusing just on the purchase events. So Commerce Analytics is a good complement for Google Analytics in that regard. So some other interesting things. Commerce Analytics requires no instrumentation to get up and running. So as soon as you start selling, you will start getting Commerce Analytics. And I think that's a really exciting thing. We also provide demographic charts and demographic analyses of your customers. Which is something that is not yet available in Google Analytics.
So are there any other synergies? Like, what else can I get from, if I leverage both, is there any some additional insight?
Yes, you should definitely leverage both. I think Google Analytics, again, provides a lot of great tools for tracking many events and engagement metrics. So again, page views, bounce rates, conversion rates, things like that. And they can also help you track your apps and your products across the platform. So if you develop for multiple platforms, Google Analytics is a great tool for that. Commerce Analytics is a great out-of-the-box, get up and running quick with no effort tool to use for a quick analysis. And we may also be providing some deeper dives into how to better analyze and better think about your sales data in particular.
So you kind of went over this a little bit in the description, but What are we hoping to provide to developers? And then how should they use it a little bit of Commerce Analytics for Commerce Analytics?
So I take that to mean, so what is the ultimate vision for Commerce Analytics?
Yeah.
And I think that's a great question. So in our UX studies, we heard a really great quote from a developer. He was saying, the hardest part about analytics in general is actually defining the right questions to ask. And that's the ultimate problem we want to solve. The truth of the matter is not everyone can afford hiring an analyst to look and crunch the numbers as a full-time job. And even if you can, sometimes there are things that you miss. Well, Google's really good at diving into the data, digging through it, and finding useful information. So let us do that. And let us tell you when we find something that's interesting. So I think it's an ambitious vision, but I think it's where we're headed.
Cool. You must have dug into a lot of data while you're developing this product. Do you have any interesting stories or anything that you found pretty fun?
Yeah. You know, as we were looking into this, one thing that really leapt out at me was just how useful just looking and analyzing sales data can really be. So, another great quote from a developer that we got in our studies went something like this. They said, you can look at daily active users, you can look at these metrics, but ultimately, at the end of the day, it's really about, are people buying things and are people spending money? I mean, if you're a business that cares about being profitable, what you really, the ground truth for you is, did somebody buy something from me? Who are my best customers? How can I get more of them? And that's where commerce analytics, I think, can really help out. So, looking at page views and daily actives, again, pretty standard, but it's harder to quantify what the value is of those things, especially if you're selling goods and services.
Okay. So why don't we just dive into the product right now?
Sure.
Check out what you got to offer.
Yeah, would love to. All right, so this is the beta version of Commerce Analytics. It is available today for a select subset of test users right now. And you can find it in your Google Checkout Merchant Center. When it becomes available, you'll see it in this Business Insights tab. So we provide a few standard charts. The first you'll notice, we've got a revenue chart, which is just showing you amount of revenue over time. So that's the landing page. And this is useful for trying to see some things like, are my sales seasonal? Was there a particular spike or a drop? Was that expected? And if so, you can sort of dive into that analysis.
Man, this guy's sales are spiky.
Yes, this is for our test merchant. So you can see here that it looks like August 31st was the biggest day thus far for our little test merchant. So we also provide a map view, so you can see a geographic heat map of where your purchasers are coming from. So here, a lot of them coming from the United States, but we can see that there are also, on a revenue basis, some activity, a decent amount of activity in Europe, Southeast Asia, and even Latin America.
We have testers everywhere.
Indeed we do. So we also provide an orders chart. And orders is a good measure of popularity. How popular are your products? How popular are certain products? And generally, this should correlate closely to revenue. But if you're running a promotion, like a 10-cent app promotion or something, you may see a large spike in orders, and you wouldn't see as big of a spike in revenue. And so I think this is a good point to point out that we have a couple of filters over here on the side. You can filter by country. You can filter by product. So you can really start diving into the data here and trying to get a more specific view into how particular products are doing over time.
That's a section that nobody wants to see.
Indeed.
Or maybe that everybody wants to see. It's like probably the most important.
Yeah, I mean, refunds, the goal here was to try to provide some insight into, is something going wrong? Where am I making sales initially that end up not being successful? So refunds, we show refunds over time and also by geography. But you could use this to really try to get a sense for, are certain parts of the world, are we getting more refunds from certain parts of the world than others? Are certain products being refunded more than others? And if so, you can start to dive into why that might be. For example, you may not want to spend as much ad revenue if you find that there are countries with a large number of refunds for particular products. So now I'll switch over to the customer's view. So this is where we're starting to provide some demographic data. And the goal here is to really provide some tools to help you segment your customers. So we want to help you answer the question, who are my best customers? So this is an early stab at doing that. But what we provide today is a breakdown of revenue and orders by age range and gender. So this is being pulled from a combination of explicitly provided and inferred demographic data. And it's aggregated up here to preserve the privacy of your customers, of course. But you can see here that the products here, the age range tends to be between 18 and 24 when broken down by revenue. Also by revenue, we can see that males hold the majority of buying power for this particular test merchant. And again, we also break it down by order volume. So again, the two should generally be, revenue and orders should be generally well correlated, but you may have promotions, you may have certain products where they are very popular with a certain demographic category. So
That is a large percentage of males. I'm guessing electronics right here.
Electronics, this is, yes. Mostly games here. So one other chart I want to point out is the unique buyers chart. And so this is just trying to give you an idea for how many unique people made a purchase on a given day. So each day has the total number of unique buyers. And this should give you an idea for how many people are you actually reaching. It also sort of starts to give you a sense for, am I reaching a small number of very loyal customers? That is, am I selling, do I have one unique buyer but 1,000 orders in a day? So do I have one person that's buying 1,000 things? Or do I have 1,000 people buying one thing? And so that can help sort of inform how you want to target your products. Do you want to really go after your rock star users? Or is this more of a product that has a broader appeal?
So now that you've gone through some of the functionality of it, like as a developer, I'm selling a bunch of apps, right? Or I'm selling one app or whatever. How should I then come into the business insights and leverage it? Like, can you go through some of the flows that you typically see?
Sure. So the first thing you need to do, I think, as any sort of business analyst, you need to come into the product having done a little bit of homework. And what that means is you should know what to expect. If you've launched a product, you should know what day that product launched, where that launched, in which countries, and whether or not you've done any sort of promotion. And you should also know what sort of impact you expect to have on sales, on orders, on unique buyers, things like that. So so know what to expect. That's the first step. And then once you get into the insights, the business insights tab, and start looking at your commerce analytics, just start diving into the data. I would suggest aggressively filtering. Look at all the charts. Test your expectations against everything that we have. So start looking at a per product revenue chart, per product orders chart, per product per country. You know, you'll never know where you'll find that little nugget of insight that can help you boost your sales. So know what to expect and then get down and dirty with the data.
So I'm not sure if you know the answer to this question, but now that I have the business insights, now that I've targeted a few audiences, what can I do to improve sales in those target audiences and that target demographic?
I see. So this is where you can start to look at, hopefully the insights that we provide here might provide you some suggestions. So for example, if I notice that I have a large customer base in a particular country, but I haven't localized any of the text, I haven't translated any of the text into the local language, that might be one way to increase engagement rates. So that's something you could do. Also, if you haven't been running any app promotions, you can start looking at, for example, the customer demographics data to try to pull out some demographic targeting information. If you tend to reach 18 to 25-year-old males, then you can start to input that into some advertising tools to help better target your app launches and your apps.
Got it. I wasn't quite sure about this, but can you filter by specific items that you're selling to see demographic data specific to the item?
So for demographics data, today we are not actually providing that filtering functionality. We're working on it. There are a lot of, as you can imagine, there are a lot of privacy concerns that we take very, very seriously here. So we want to make sure that when we do provide that sort of filtering functionality here, that we can do so in a way that's safe for customers. However, on the sales and revenue and orders charts, we do provide the ability to filter down by country and again by product. So,
cool.
And of course, time.
Super useful. This seems like something that's really useful that comes pretty much out of the box for merchants and developers. How would they access it through their own merchant accounts? Or is there any way to access it or join the beta early?
Yeah, so we have, let me present the link here. If you're interested, We have a Google form, which you can reach at this shortened URL. I encourage you to fill out the form. We can't guarantee that we'll be able to bring you on to the beta immediately. But the good news is we're looking at rolling this out much more broadly in the coming months. So very shortly, we expect everyone who uses Google to sell to have Commerce Analytics. Again, go to the form, fill it out if you're interested. We'd love to hear from you. We also have a section on there for additional comments. So if you have any suggestions for things that you would like to see, things that you would find very useful, please do let us know. So, looking forward to having some users, some more users, and some more feedback on this.
Cool. I mean, I think it's really awesome. I think it provides super easy insight into what you're selling and how you can improve your sales. And great. That's all the questions that I have for you. Let's see cool. If there are any live questions.
Sure.
I'm looking at the moderator right now. So it doesn't look like these questions are actually related to Commerce Analytics. I am a Brazilian developer, and nowadays payments in Brazil are very complex. PayPal is a more straightforward way to pay. How can Google fix this problem? I think
it's a big question.
I mean, internationalization has always been a huge question yep. with Google Wallet, yep. and we're always trying to improve the number of countries that we support. But in order for us to expand in new countries, we always have to, you know, go through the regular rules and regulations and follow the proper paperwork, and that's probably why it takes some time to expand internationally. But we are trying to do it. Let's see about the YouTube. Just 1 second. Well, I have a few questions for you. A few more questions for you, if you don't mind.
Lay it on me.
So, are we doing anything with Google Offers? Like, I know that as a merchant, I can sell offers. Will my offers be tracked within Commerce Analytics, so I can like really quickly figure out, you know, who's buying from where, and then maybe target those areas with better offers or like more coupons or ads or whatever?
Yeah, absolutely. I think the short answer is we're looking into it. The general sentiment, though, is that anyone that uses Google to sell should be able to have Commerce Analytics. And in general, anyone who sells something could benefit from a tool like this. That's sort of the way that we feel on the team. So I'll sort of leave it there.
Got
but
it.
Very interesting stuff.
We have one more question. So I hear this is what Amazon does, is because they have a sense of the entire marketplace. And this is, I'm not actually sure, this is just, I haven't been in an Amazon market, but this is just word of mouth and anecdotal. But I hear what they do is because they have an entire sense of who's selling what and then how often and the frequency of it, they can actually say that these items will be your top sellers, nobody else is selling this item, so you should increase the price, and like other stuff like that. Is that an area that we want to get into, or like that, or can you not talk about?
I will say that there's a lot of very interesting things that we can do. there's a lot of very interesting things that we can do, and so stay tuned.
Stay tuned. Join the beta or sign up for the beta, and eventually, can you get into when we expect to have open access for this, or where this is still a work in progress?
So the exact date is to be determined, but we will, I shouldn't say that. It's coming in the next, I would say, 2 months.
Nice. Very soon. Mm-hmm. Cool. I'm looking forward to it. Mm-hmm. And with that, I think that's all the questions we have for you today.
Great.
No more of this interrogation.
Thanks. Well, thanks for having me, Paul.
Yeah, well, thanks for joining. Mm-hmm. And we'll have another Google Payments Live in 2 weeks.